今天跟大家介绍，奥奇教授，高兴他可以到我们系上来给一个演讲。那他是两年前刚从那个京都大学退休，然后我们这边就把他聘到台湾来，然后他大部分时间待在成功大学或者是台大那边。那他的研究方向主要是。 气体动力学，那这方面的东西，他算是世界上的有名的专家。那他跟非常多的最顶尖的数学家合作，他本身不是数学系毕业，但是他做工作非常的有趣，那所以我今天特别请他讲比较简单的东西，然后最后会跟大家介绍一些相关的数学工作。
Thank you very much for a nice introduction, though I don't understand. It is my great pleasure and honor to be here in this very important university. As he explained, I retired from Kyoto University, from Mechanical Department of Mechanical Engineering Science last year. And then after that, I have been working in Taiwan. The National Center for Theoretical Sciences, NCTS, the National Taiwan University, and also the Master Department of National Cheng University. And also I'm very much enjoyed my stay in Taiwan. It's a very nice place. Today I'm going to give a talk, but this is a very elemental introduction and some very basic problems. Kinetic theory of gases. So, because this is a working talk and most of the audience students, so first I start with the brief introduction. What is the kinetic theory of gases? Or the same thing as neapolitic gas dynamics or molecular gas dynamics. And it's very elementary. So, as you know, gas is composed of many molecules. It's an ensemble of many molecules. So probably you remember the number Avogadro number, and it's 6 × 10⁻², a huge number. So this is the number of molecules contained in a gas of one mole. And the gas molecules are moving. And the average speed is like sound speed. So this means that 300 meters per second. So it flies very fast, very high speed. But at the same time, in the ordinary gas, ordinary means, for instance, the air in the room, the atmospheric pressure, a lot of collisions. The collision means two molecules approach, and then they enter the influence of their potential, and then they change the speed and velocity and direction. They change the velocity. Okay, so this is called collision. And so you can imagine that two billiard balls collide. And then after collision, it goes somewhere. And we usually call this interaction collision. There are a lot of collisions. And so there is a quantity called mu-fibers. Mu-fibers is a average distance between two successive collisions. So this is in this room, the mu pass is like 10⁻⁶ cm. So this is extremely short. So the collisions are so frequent. So therefore, around us, such a dramatic events are happening, but we don't notice, we don't see. And we can only the average So sometimes we say that there is a wind of 5 meters per second. But this is not the speed of velocity of molecules. It's an average. So, so you see some small, very small volume. Then you average all the velocities of molecules. Then you get 5 meters per second in this direction. So we can perceive only such average. And to consider the behavior of gas, the important concept is velocity distribution of gas molecules. So how the velocities of gas molecules are distributed. So say the C is a molecular velocity. So it's a velocity, therefore it's a three-dimensional vector. However, for just simplicity, this is 1D, one-dimensional schematic figure, not real. But, or you can consider just one component of the three components of the vector. Then, this vertical axis indicates the number of molecules, and the horizontal axis indicates velocity. So this is exactly speaking, how many molecules are there in this velocity, like that. And when the gas molecule velocity is very high, the speed is high, then there will be few molecules. Therefore, this is small. And also this other side, the opposite direction, high speed molecules is small. But there should be some concentration of the around the average. Okay. And when there is a frequent collision in ordinary gas, this shape becomes a Gaussian distribution. And in the case of gas, it is called the Maxwellian distribution. And it is expressed in this way. For all this, N, T, V have a physical meaning. So C is the molecular velocity. And N is the number density of molecules. Number density means how many molecules are there per unit volume. Or instead of the number density, you can also consider mass density. How much mass contains the small unit volume. Okay. And V is a macroscopic velocity, average velocity, and this T is the temperature. And this corresponds to V is the average of velocity. So in this is a Maxwellian distribution in a very shape like this. And then the peak is the average. So the position of the peak is V here. And the square root of 2RT, here R is a gas constant. And the square root of 2RT indicates this width, standard deviation of this distribution. And then this number density corresponds to the area below this curve. In reality, it is a three-dimensional volume, but in this schematic figure, this area. So then the important thing is that if you specify, in this situation, if you specify the average velocity, temperature, and number density, then this shape is completely determined. So you need only in this situation, under frequent collision, you need only need the information of this quantities. This is macroscopic quantity. So then this V, T, A can be the function of time T and position X. For instance, if you go to outside, then temperature can be lower. But still, you have this distribution, Maxwellian distribution. And in general, the V, T, and vary depending on time and position. Function of time T and position X. And such a situation is called local equilibrium. So in this room also you have this very shape distribution, but inside the refrigerator also you have a very shape, but the temperature is different. So depending on the place or time, the shape is similar, but precise shape is different. Okay. So this local equilibrium corresponds to usual macroscopic fluid mechanics. So in fluid mechanics you have equations, partial differential equation for velocity, temperature and density in general. And for instance, this is a different state. And what is the fast flow? Fast means to say in the positive direction, x direction, then this distribution is shifted to the right. And then this average velocity becomes higher, and this is the fast flow, for example, in the x direction. And the cold flow, the temperature is low, therefore the distribution becomes 3. And the low density flow, but low density means still a lot of collisions. So ordinary pressure, maybe one half of the atmospheric pressure or something like that. Then the height of the distribution becomes low. But the real low density gas, real means like inside vacuum facilities or upper atmosphere. But also the same thing happens in a very small, tiny scale, micro scale. Then in that case, the collision, intermolecular collision is not frequent enough to form this Maxwellian distribution. Then the distribution deviates from this Maxwellian, from Gaussian, and from local equilibrium. So the distribution can be like this. So the measure of deviation from the Gaussian distribution is given, roughly given by a number called the Crookes number. So this is defined by the ratio of mean free path that I mentioned, the average distance between two successive collisions, mean free path divided by the characteristic length of the system. So if you consider a flow past the body, then the size of the body is the characteristic length to this ratio. And ordinary, if you consider the system like size 10 centimeters, then Crookes number becomes 10 to the minus 7 because the mean free path is 10 to the minus 6 centimeters in this room. So Crookes number becomes like this. This is practically straight. So the low density gas, low density gas, mean free path can be known. Some 10 meters, 100 meters, even 1,000 meters in the orbit of a space shuttle. And on the other hand, this gas in microscales, its characteristic length can be very small. Then the Crookes number can take much larger value of the order of unit or even larger. Then in principle, the Crookes number can take any positive value between 0 and infinity. And when the Crookes number is close to zero, then it is local equilibrium. And this mathematical limit is called the free dynamic limit and the continuum limit. And near this limit, the gas is in local equilibrium. And the macroscopic free dynamics in general is okay. And the other extreme case that I will come up later, this case, if it passes infinitely long compared with characteristic length. So in that case, you can freely neglect the effect of intermolecular collisions. Just the molecules interact only with the boundary. This is called the free molecular flow. And the general Crookes number, say order one, the distribution can be like this. So in that case, what happens is that also you can have, you can define the average velocity is this velocity. Also, you can define the standard deviation of this. You can have a standard deviation from this distribution, but you can define the temperature in that way. And also the number density is the area below this curve. However, the shape of this distribution is not uniquely determined by this quantity. Previously, when the Gaussian shape is formed, then these things are enough to determine completely the distribution. But in general, it's not enough. So you have to handle the distribution itself. And the equation for this distribution is called the Boltzmann equation, which was introduced by the famous Austrian physicist Ludwig Boltzmann in 1872. And so this is the basic equation of the molecular gas dynamics, kinetic theory of gases. And in that sense, molecular gas dynamics, or kinetic theory of gas, is the gas dynamics of the distribution itself. And in that sense, it is more general than the usual gas dynamics. Because the gas, usual, the ordinary gas dynamics is just a limit of this case. So in fact, the fluid dynamic equation can be derived from the Boltzmann equation as a limit. Okay. And then, what is the effect of deviation from Gaussian? That can be seen easily. With one example, there are not many examples, because just you don't see it yet. So one of the examples is Crookes radiometer. I will come back to this problem later, if I have enough time. And this is the tomb of Ludwig Boltzmann in Vienna, Central Cemetery. And this is magnified. So here is an equation. So this is S equal K logarithm W, is a famous equation for the entropy. So the tombstone has an equation. But Boltzmann equation is too complicated for this space. Okay, so the Boltzmann equation already it was proposed a long time ago, and it's a classical equation. And there have been published many books on that, mathematical or physical books. And for instance, the Italian applied mathematician Kazuo Aoki has published many books on the Boltzmann equation, including the biography of Ludwig Boltzmann, entitled Ludwig Boltzmann, the man who trusted atoms. It was published in from Cambridge University Press. So it's an important equation. It has been an important equation in non-equilibrium statistical mechanics. And nowadays, also it's a practical equation in therapeutic gas dynamics, the entry of the space vehicle and so on, and also microfreezing of vacuum technology. But also the important this gives provides the important topic in the statistical physics and also applied mathematics. In particular, already long time ago, in 2010, Cedric Villani got the Fields Medal in relation to Boltzmann equation. But he was the director of the Institute Anne Poincaré, but he decided, because he became a politician. he got the Fields Medal because of all his proofs of nonlinear Landau damping and the convergence to equilibrium for the Boltzmann equation. So maybe the Landau damping was more important, but still, this is also one of the reasons of his accomplishment. Of which he got the Fields Medal. So I will come back to this point later.
Excuse me, I'm a new voice here, so okay. I'm wondering, what's the equilibrium for the Boltzmann equation?
Equilibrium?
Yeah. It's under particular distribution?
Yes, Maxwell distribution.
Gaussian. Okay.
And with constant pressure, constant density, constant temperature, the constant velocity. So maybe velocity zero, but if you have a box, then you keep the gas for a long time, then it has a box, gas goes to decrease velocity. And this, in that case, this distribution is Gaussian, with constant temperature, constant velocity zero, and constant density. I'll come back to this point later. Okay. So this is Cedric Villani. This is from the homepage of ICM 2010. And here I took that sentence from here. It may be too small. Okay, so then a little more serious introduction. As I said, the fundamental quantity in kinetic theory, that is the unknown function of the Boltzmann equation, is the velocity distribution function, which is in general the function of time t and position x and molecular velocity c. These are independent variables. And the physical meaning is, as I said, it's a distribution in the velocity, and but more precisely, it's a mass density or a number density, which is up to you. But I prefer to use mass density in six-dimensional head space, x and c. So this is a x, this contains three-dimensional, and this c also contains three-dimensional. This is a schematic figure. And in this one particle head space, a six-dimensional head space, if you consider a small box, dx and dc, around the point x and c, then the molecular mass inside this small box at time t is expressed in this way. So this way is the mass density in this head space. And then if you just cut this means that xt for each fixed time t, there is a mountain on this plane. Okay? And if you cut this, then the cross section is the distribution that I showed you. This one, the cross section. At some point, at some line, at some x. And once you know the velocity distribution function, then all the macroscopic quantities, then mass density, flow velocity, temperature, stress tensor, and heat flow vector, all of them are expressed in terms of the integral of the velocity distribution function F over the whole molecular velocity space. But this is just an integral of F and V. Flow velocity is the average of C, molecular velocity, over this distribution, and so on. In this way, the important thing is to find this F. Then you can get all the information, macroscopic information. And this is the Boltzmann equation. Usually, when there is no external force, the Boltzmann equation is written in this form. And the left-hand side is quite simple. Only first order derivative with respect to time and position. So this is this is a directional derivative in the direction of the molecular trajectory. And but the right-hand side is quite complicated. It expresses the effects of a binary collision to the change of F. And it is usually written in the following form, but I omit all detailed explanation. Just to give a look at this point, it contains five-fold integrals, whole molecular velocity space and the direction, five-fold integrals, and then there is a product of F, so this means the nonlinear in F. But the X and T doesn't have any operation on the right-hand side. On the right-hand side, x and t are just parameters. Operation, though, with respect the integral of molecular velocity. And then the information about the intermolecular collision in a model of intermolecular potential, like hard sphere, lead sphere, yeah, so some power law potential and so on, are all concentrated on this function b. But I omit the details. This precise structure is not relevant to my talk, the rest of my talk today. But I must mention one thing. Since this equation is very complicated, it is not easy to apply this equation to practical problems. Therefore, very often, the simplified model Boltzmann equation is used. And one of the simplest, and the most widely used model equation is the so-called BGK model, or relaxation model. BGK after Bartner, Gross, and Crookes. 1954, long time ago. The same equation was proposed independently by Pilat the same year. And in this model, the right-hand side of the Boltzmann equation is replaced by such symbol. So, constant times density times Fe minus L. Here, Fe is a local maximum. So it's very simple. It looks very different from this equation. In fact, it is very simple. However, concerning non-linearity, it is not so good. Because in this equation, Boltzmann equation, non-linearity is just a product of F. Quadratic non-linearity. However, in this equation, you see the temperature and velocity inside the exponential. And the velocity and temperature are the integral of F. So this means that F is inside the exponential. So they need a much highly non-linear equation from the original Boltzmann equation. And but actually this is very simple. You know, in particular for numerical simulation, it is much simpler. And the good point is that this model satisfies all the fundamental properties of the Boltzmann equation, the conservation laws and the famous Boltzmann H theorem. And also, this is not so very far from the original Boltzmann equation, as it looks. This corresponds to the Maxwell molecules, in which the intermolecular force is inversely proportional to the fifth power of the distance between two molecules. So if you consider such an interaction, then this minus term is reduced to exactly like this, constant times density times F. So for this molecule, Maxwell molecule, minus F part is exact. And only you have to introduce some model to get this one. Namely, you have to assume that all the distribution of the molecules after collision is distributed to according to local Maxwell distribution. And then you get this one. So I use this model data. And then I have to also mention the boundary condition. The conventional boundary condition, I should mention conventional boundary condition. In the Boltzmann equation, you have to specify, in principle, the velocity distribution function for deflected molecules, or outgoing molecules from the boundary. And namely, C minus V double dot N positive. N is an internal vector pointing into the gas. The simplest boundary condition is specular deflection. That's the incident molecules are specularly deflected. And sometimes in the statistical mechanics, this boundary condition is used, or also mathematics. And in mathematics, maybe periodic boundary condition is more used. But this is too simple and similar. So more practical and the simplest boundary condition is the diffuse deflection. So here, the idea is that the molecules hit the boundary, and then very short time it is trapped inside the boundary. Then interact with the molecules forming the boundary, and then after summarization, it is re-emitted. So this means that the re-emitted molecules are in thermal equilibrium with the boundary. Therefore, this half part should be the Maxwellian distribution, equilibrium distribution, which temperature Tw, the same temperature as the boundary, and the velocity Vw, same velocity as the boundary. And but then we don't specify density. Then we have to impose the condition that there is no net mass flux across the boundary. So then this condition gives this sigma W, the following expression in this way. That is, this is the flux due to the impinging molecule. Okay. So the sigma W is should be like this, in such a way that there is no heat, no mass flux across the boundary. So this contains unknown function F, this part. But it's not so simple. Okay, convergence to equilibrium. So here, very fundamental and simple problem, but not so simple mathematically. So you can suppose that you have a box container with uniform temperature, constant temperature, TW, and then you put the gas inside. Then you give it disturbance, you give disturbance, then you wait for a long time. Then gas should, the gas inside the box should approach the equilibrium state with the same temperature as the boundary. And also zero velocity because the box is at rest. So the final Maxwellian, final equilibrium distribution should be like that. Temperature TW and zero mean velocity. And then the density rho zero is determined by initial condition. I mean that it depends on how much gas you put inside. So there is an average density of the initial condition. This should be approached. And so this is the collisional gas, with collision. And collision is whatever. With collisions, this is the important problem for the equilibrium, to equilibrium. The Boltzmann equation, and many important mathematicians have investigated this. And also the Cedric Villani that I mentioned is one of them. And he considered the stick, not like this one, but the boundary condition, he considered boundary condition is a specular reflection or periodic box. And then debated Villani were able to prove that this, or you have to define some absolute norm, but the F approach is the final Maxwellian with the order of inverse power of time, but this power is arbitrary. So this is almost the explanation. And this power K becomes large. And so they have to assume the existence of a smooth solution of the Boltzmann equation. And the smoother, the larger K. And but they were not able to, physically, the physicists know that it's an explanation, but they are not able to prove the explanation in detail. But in this case, the final Maxwellian is slightly different from this one, because the specular reflection or periodic boundary condition, there is no information about the boundary temperature. The specular reflection is completely adiabatic. So then the temperature of the final Maxwellian is also determined from initial condition because of the energy conservation. And later, for periodic boundary condition, exponential decay was proved by Brandan, Michelin, and Moore. And also for diffuse reflection that I mentioned, the more realistic boundary condition, Villani extended its proof for this case, 2009. And then, concerning small deviation from equilibrium state, close to equilibrium, there was a proof of exponential decay by Yang-Guo. And quite recently, there's Professor Jiang, in collaboration with Li-Bin He, obtained a much nicer result. You will have a chance to listen to his result here. Okay. And then the problem, another problem that my interest was many years ago, if there is no collision between gas molecules, what happens? But still, the gas molecules do not interact with each other. However, the gas molecules, so this is the Crookes number, is infinitely large. So in this case, the gas molecules only interact with the boundary. But still, boundary is kept at temperature TW. Therefore, the final result is also should be the Maxwellian distribution, equilibrium state, with the same temperature at the boundary. So I was interested in this problem. And so there was a mathematical proof by Leif Alperin and Nubi. They showed that the solution approaches, the solution of the Boltzmann equation approaches final Maxwellian, even without collision, molecular collision. So this is relaxation is caused only by gas surface interaction. And they didn't mention anything about the convergence, plate of convergence. So I was interested in this, and I expected that the approach to the final Maxwellian is very slow. So something like this is my our guess, and, something like 1/1 some power of t time, and t is the dimension of box. Dimension is just if the usual box is 3D and 2D box is a cylinder, if it is long cylinder, and 1D box is the gap between two plates. So, and then we did a numerical study already a long time ago. And so the case of collisionless gas, when Crookes number is infinitely large, then you can neglect the effect of intermolecular collision. That is, the Boltzmann, you can neglect the right-hand side of the Boltzmann equation. And the Boltzmann equation is reduced to such simple first-order partial differential equation. And immediately, you can write down the solution. That is, F is constant along the characteristic line, namely the trajectory of molecules, gas molecules. Since there is no external force, gas molecules just go straight. And then, so this solution means that if you are at time t at the position x, and you look at the value of f for velocity c, then you just trace back, and so the value is the same as the value of f at time t 0, and this position, and the same velocity c. Along this line, f is constant. Therefore, already the problem is already half, already solved. And then this decay problem approach the equilibrium. So this is 1D case, 1D box. 1D box means between two infinitely wide plane. And the physical quantity depends only on x. And the velocity, concerning velocity, you have three components. X1, F, Xx, Xy, and Xd. And but the equation contains only Xx. And some initial condition and boundary condition, I assume the diffuse reflection. So here, just I take the temperature as 1. Therefore, this is a simple diffuse reflection boundary condition. This is Maxwellian with temperature 1. And velocity 0. And we have this sigma. And the sigma is expressed as the integral of impinging molecules that I expect. And then, I omit the detail. So for instance, if you are here, then you fix the velocity, then you trace back, and for your velocity is something like this, then the f is constant along this line. And then you, sorry, it is a horizontal axis is x, and the vertical axis is t, time t. Then you are at time t, and the position x here. Then if your velocity is like this, then you trace back, and you reach the initial condition, then you take the value from the initial condition, then you know the value of f for this velocity. And if your velocity is like this, then you trace back, then you reach the boundary, then you take the value from boundary condition. But you don't know the boundary condition, because boundary condition is unknown through sigma contains f. But if you consider this the same thing on the boundary, then you get the integral equation of this sigma w. This is a density of flux or deflected molecules. So you get the integral equation of the sigma w t, sigma w plus and sigma w minus, like this. And then we solve this integral equation numerically. Okay. And this is the result. I show only the result. It's a temperature, and 1 is the temperature of the boundary. But here I put the tilde to indicate the dimensional quantity. And so my initial condition, dimension temperature is 1/2 and 2. So 0.5 means that the initial temperature. So I consider also initial condition is a uniform Maxwellian distribution, equilibrium, but different temperature from the temperature of the boundary. So this 0.5 means that initial temperature is 1/2 or the temperature of the boundary. And 2 means that the initial temperature is twice of the bound, the temperature of the boundary. Then I look at the time evolution of the temperature at this point. And this is the figure. And this is double logarithmic plot. And after some, the logarithm is base 10, the common logarithm. Therefore, the form is the time 10 to the 4. And after some time, all the life is different initial condition at this point, then it tends to approach straight line. And if you measure the gradient, then it tends to approach minus 1. So this line goes to the curve tends to the straight line with gradient minus 1. So this means that the temperature decays 1 over t, like this. Okay? And also for other points, I showed this graph at 10.2, but also other points. So this means that with appropriate norm, maybe L1 norm, the decays 1 over t. So this, we are able to give some pieces of numerical evidence for this decay. So somehow our guess was correct. And so now, this is 1D case. And also we consider also 2D case. But only circular cylinder. And 3D box is only sphere. And starting from uniform equilibrium. Uniform state, uniform equilibrium state with different temperatures. And then we confirmed, numerically confirmed that decay is something like that we get. Then I showed, but this 1D case, how the distribution function approached from initial distribution to final distribution in the video. And I show the time evolution of this g. G is a marginal velocity distribution function. That is, f is integrated. F is the function of time t, and one dimension, this is 1D case, by the space coordinate x, and three components of the molecular velocity. But here, it is integrated out over the cy and cz, the two components parallel to the plane. So only this is t, the function of time t, and position x, and the x component of molecular velocity c. So I show the graph as a time evolution of this g at this point, the middle point, and also the side point here as a function of c, x. And so this is the initial condition is that 2, the initial temperature is 2 means that the temperature, the gas initial temperature is twice of the temperature of the boundary. So this means that originally, the black curve, the temperature, high temperature means the distribution is white. Okay. So this black curve indicates initial condition, and this red curve is the final distribution. How this evolves? Interaction to the boundary. So slow molecules, it takes a long time for slow molecules near zero to interact with boundary. And the velocity zero, molecule with velocity zero, never interacts with the boundary. Therefore, only except to zero velocity distribution approaches. And this is already not initial point is not zero already started, but this is the point close the boundary, close to the boundary. So therefore, the distribution is not symmetric. So it approaches the delta curve in this way. Just some small oscillation. we didn't expect such a complicated approach. Okay. Then, so as I said, we are able to provide some numerical evidence for such decay. And later mathematical study. So we did also something theoretical, but not a very rough estimate. And then later, already long time ago, so years ago, three Taiwanese mathematician, Kinetic University, my colleague now, and Professor Tai Yu, and then Tsai, I don't remember his last name. They consider also spherical geometry, but from arbitrary initial condition, they are able to prove mathematically, rigorously, that this decay using a probability theory, the law of large numbers. So I am very happy that we introduce some rigorous mathematics, I believe. And then what happens when there is a collision? And so this is a 1D box, again. And I use the BGK model, because of the Boltzmann equation. Then again, the initial temperature is twice of the temperature of the mountain. Then, I don't have a movie here. But this is the temperature, change of temperature. This is time, but not the logarithm, the time itself. And this is the logarithm of T minus TW. TW, so T infinity is TW. And so this should be 1. So this goes to 0. But then question number is 10. This means that the mean-free path is 10 times of the distance between two planes. So that's a real one. You see, in this curve, it tends to straight line. So this means that this temperature, then this is some kind of mode, but temperature, T minus T1, T minus 1, decays something like this. And this coefficient of the exponent function depends on the Crookes number, the Kazuo Aoki function. Okay. And when Crookes number is large, then you don't see within this time, you don't see the approach to straight line. This takes a very long time. Since question number is large, almost a equation of this, almost algebraic, and finally it goes to exponential decay. And as question number decreases, then it becomes faster. And the question number is 1, then half this decay. Then further decrease of the question number gives slower decay. 0.01, like this. Then also, the approach is like this. That this continuity is not as extreme as collision decay. But still, with collision, you have a propagation discontinuity. Okay? So therefore, is this boundary, with boundary, and if you consider that Boltzmann equation is Boltzmann equation for cutoff potential.
This is the center. The voltage unit is center.
Ah, sorry. It's the center, yes. Center. You see, even with collision, there's a propagation discontinuity. Therefore, in this case, you cannot assume the existence of a smooth solution of the Boltzmann equation. No cutoff potential is okay, but cutoff potential is not too. Then, very quickly, I didn't know. Okay, so this, as I said, the effect of deviation from Gaussian can be seen by this. But this is called Crookes radiometer, invented by William Crookes, British Kinetic. And so, have you seen this? Never seen. Now you have a glass balloon, and there are four bands, and it can rotate. It is suspended by a needle, and it can rotate freely. It is completely closed. But if you put in the light, like this, exposed to the light, then it this lens rotates. It is completely closed, but it rotates. Why? And if you put this in the sunshine, sunlight, then it rotates very fast. You cannot count the rotation. And so there are two tricks. First one, that the vein, one side of the vein is black, and the other side is metallic, reflecting. This is one trick. And the second trick is that gas is sucked out from the bulb. But it is not a very high vacuum, but it is a simple glass bulb. If the brilliant vacuum, immediately glass bulb crash. And, the pressure is between 10 to the minus 3rd to 10 to the minus 5th of atmospheric pressure. And therefore, based on the vein, constant number is 10 to the minus 3rd to 0.1, so not very highly nearby. But anyway, this is the effect of gas reabsorption, or effect of micro scale. And usually explanation also, this is a classical phenomenon, and also the important physicists consider this. And so the usual explanation is like this. If this is the vein, and one side is black and the other side is not, then heat is absorbed. If heat is exposed to the light, then the black side absorbs more heat. Then it becomes hot. But the other side does not absorb heat much. Therefore, the hot side, there is a difference, temperature difference between both sides of the plate. And then the molecules hitting the hot side interact with the molecules inside this hot plate, and then reflecting with the higher energy, namely high speed. Then, but this side no. And then this high speed molecule reflected high speed molecule push the plate, and then it moves in this direction. So this is the usual explanation. But it's not so simple as this. And anyway, this is low density gas flow caused by the temperature difference and the resulting force acting on the veins. So we considered a very simple model of this already long time ago. A simple plate with one side heating in a graphite gas in a square box. So two-dimensional problem, in a square box and a heated plate. And the left side is still just the same as the box of this container. And the only light side is heated to T1. Then what happens? Then we did a numerical simulation of this problem using BGK model and obviously Crookes number and gas surface interaction of diffuse reflection that I mentioned. And we solved the problem numerically by finite difference method. But this problem is a bit difficult because this sharp edge and also the temperature discontinuity produces a singularity of the solution on the boson plate. So we devised a special finite difference method which is able to describe the discontinuity. So this is one example. So here, maybe I omitted this. Okay, so anyway, the solution contains a discontinuity. So we have to describe this discontinuity precisely, otherwise. Also, the macroscopic quantities have singularity, so you cannot describe the singularity in macroscopic quantities correctly. Anyway, so this is the velocity field. Maybe better to show this. The constant number is rather small, and it's a velocity field in the upper half. This, so here is a plate, and this first quadrant and second quadrant are need to separate to show the velocity field on the plane. Not attached. And the when constant number is rather small, here the velocity is rather concentrated near the edge. And even smaller constant number, only very tiny part of the near the edge. And so I magnify this part. Then the flow is, this is a large constant number. The large constant number means that constant number, sorry, I didn't say, here the temperature ratio is 2. The this side is twice over this. It's not a really large temperature difference. And this length of the plate is one fourth of this side. And so the magnified figure, in this case, Mifi path is five times of the size of the plate. So in this case, almost a uniform flow is in this here. But when Crookes number is decreased, so this is near the boundary, the Crookes number is decreased, so Mifi path, even in this magnified figure, only this part, magnified figure, the flow is localized. This is temperature field. When Crookes number is small, then you see this is an isothermal line, constant line of constant temperature. It concentrates on the heat. Okay. So this means that this point is a similar point of the temperature. Temperature is not uniquely defined. So this thing, to describe this singularity, you have to describe the discontinuity of the velocity distribution acting correctly. And I skip all this. And then we can compute the force acting on the plate. But the interesting thing is that we can also compute the local force acting on the plate. Local force means that P11 plus is the force acting on the light side in this direction, and P minus is the force acting on the left surface in this direction. Therefore, the difference is the force in this direction from the right to the left, and this is so locally at each point. So this is the distribution of this force. So this zero is the center of the plate, and 0.5 is the edge of the plate. Okay, from the center to the edge, when the constant number is infinitely large, then it is uniform. The force, local force, is uniform. But when constant number is decreased, and decreased to 0.01, then most of the part, almost no force. Only near the edge, you have a force. And so this is a numerical result. Then I come back to this physical explanation. As I said, this is please recall the previous explanation that the molecules hitting on the hot spots are reflected with higher speed, and then this push. But this is not so simple as I said, because so this is correct when there is no molecular interaction. When constant number is large, this explanation is correct. So therefore, this corresponds to this, even this. However, what happens when the collisions are frequent? Then, it is true that the reflected molecules are energetic. But this energetic particles, high-speed molecules, kick out the incident molecules. So then, for incident molecules, there is difficulty reaching the plate. So this means that the number of incident molecules is reduced. Then therefore, the total momentum is reduced. Then this reduction is such a way that there is no force acting on the plate. Okay. So this happens in the middle of the plate. So therefore, when the collision is frequent, you don't have a force in the middle part of the plate. However, so this is the middle of the plate, so there is the effect of kicking out. However, near the edge, so this is the edge, then there are a lot of molecules in the side. And these molecules can come to the plate without the much effect of kicking out. So then near the edge, more molecules can hit the boundary, so this compensates the effect of this kicking out. And therefore, the force acts near the edge. So this, when the constant number is small, the constant number is not so small, not so large, not so small. So there are still many collisions. So in that case, the presence of the edge is important. Yes, sir.
can explain again why 1Q from the side is necessarily like, is likely to be kicked?
Yeah, because here, lifted molecules, usually in general, high speed. And therefore, in general, high speed, most of the molecules coming here is higher speed than the molecules coming from the right. And therefore, on the average, more people are bounced back. And then more molecules are bounced back because of this high speed molecules coming. And therefore, this results in the reduction of the number of incident molecules.
But what happens to the side one?
And then on the side, right. Yes, it is true, but then here, the side, above this edge, there are many molecules. And of course, these molecules are also affected by the molecules coming from there, but the probability is small. And most part of the molecule coming from there can reach the plate near the edge without suffering from the collision of this energetic particle. So therefore, reduction of the number of incident molecules are much less near the edge. And then this effect, the reason that I explained, the reduction of the incident molecules are compensated by the molecule from the side, and then this is whether the explanation is more or less correct near the edge. So this is the mechanism. I skip this. And finally, this is the last slide. So even some years ago, already some people were able to do the simulation of the Boltzmann equation for moving bands. So this is a result from my Guillaume from Bordeaux. The paper was published in 2016, and they simulate moving bands. This is a 2D. But the reason is the computation was not very precise. There is some oscillation of the temperature field, so the temperature should be completely stationary. Okay, fine. Maybe I exceeded 1 hour, sorry. Sorry, and I stop here. Thank you very much.
So, did I say anything about the edge is more important?
No, they didn't say that. They didn't do that. Their purpose is just to simulate the moving boundary. So they are numerical people.
So at least now there is no analysis given to the window.
Yeah, we did the simulation of the station update, and those results show us.
Analysis
is difficult, yes.
Can I have my one? 如果没有问题，我们再一次谢谢。
好，谢谢。